Good morning. It's Pastor Maria here from St. Paul Lutheran Church on US Highway 40 in Altamont. Welcome to a brief devotional time this week. I'm thinking this morning of all the things that I am grateful for on this Thanksgiving holiday. Memories are flooding through my heart and my mind. This morning, I made a quick phone call and left a message for one of my aunts. She hosted the Thanksgiving holiday for many years as I was growing up. There are very fond memories of those times gathered together. And now I'm charged with making some of the things that she made when I come to a family gathering. So, dear Aunt Linda Lou, thank you for teaching me how to make pickle roll-ups. Our family functions would never be the same without them. And yes, they are delicious, but I think it's the memory of having those at Aunt Linda's house that means so much at holiday time. For no matter whether you are near or far, we remember you when we make those and when we share those. What are your favorite memories? What are you grateful for this day? I know that holiday time can be a tough space for some people and some families. And so for you, know that however you celebrate, it's okay. The holidays are not always holly and jolly, and we want to respect how each person chooses to celebrate them, whether they are gathering with friends, family, or other people, or whether they are at home by themselves. God is there with you. For you are never alone. The last few weeks in our worship space, as our offering is brought forward, we have been singing this little song. I say little because it's just a portion of a larger song attributed to Don Moen, and it's called Give Thanks. And here are the words. Give thanks with a grateful heart. Give thanks to the Holy One. Give thanks because he's given Jesus Christ, his son. Give thanks with a grateful heart. Give thanks to the Holy One. Give thanks because he's given Jesus Christ, his son. And now let the weak say, I am strong. Let the poor say, I am rich, because of what the Lord has done for us. And now let the weak say, I am strong. Let the poor say, I am rich, because of what the Lord has done for us. Give thanks. I love singing this song because it lifts up the lowly, the weak, the poor, and they are giving thanks because of what God has done for them. It's really easy sometimes to reflect on all the things that we don't have, all the things that we wish we had, all the ways in which we are hurting and lost. But if the poor can say that they are rich and the weak can say that they are strong, it's because they find their strength in the Lord. It's because they trust in God to provide through the love of other people. And so this Thanksgiving Day, whether you are feeling poor or rich, weak or strong, grateful and abundantly blessed or meh, God is there with you. And we give thanks to God for you, for your presence in this crazy world. The world is a better place because you are here. Perhaps if you are having a big meal today with family and friends, you might do a little activity together as we did as a faith community last weekend. I'm sitting in front of our giving thanks tree, and we had the opportunity to take these leaves. They say, I am thankful for on them, and write on there what we are thankful for. As I came in this morning and looked at our Thanksgiving tree, I'm in awe of many of the things that have been written on those leaves. For family, for food, for shelter, for health, for friendship, for butterflies, for my basketball team, for my coach, for my pastor, for my neighbor. Simple yet grand things to be grateful for. Many of them reflecting on people in our lives. God created the heavens and the earth and the people and all habitation, the trees, the sunrise, the sunset. And so may we find that we are able to give thanks for even the simplest of things. Perhaps it was waking up this day. Perhaps it's an eager anticipation of seeing a family member you haven't seen in a while. Or maybe it's in having a day off and being able to rest and watch a parade on TV or a TV show or movie you've wanted to watch. Or maybe preparing your home for Christmas. Whatever you find yourself doing this day, I hope that you would take a moment to reflect on the things that you are grateful for. For if the poor say they are rich and the weak say they are strong because of the Lord, maybe it's just the simplicity of being thankful for what the Lord has done for us through Jesus, giving us hope for the days ahead, shining light in the darkness, and for the promise of the life that we have in Him and will have in the future through Him. And so we say this day, thank you, God, for giving us your Son. Let us pray. Holy God, we give you thanks for the gift of giving us your Son, and for all of the little things that we often forget to say thank you for. Be it our homes, our health, our families, food, shoes, people in our lives, the ability to do the things we love to do and the things we don't want to do. And God, we thank you for resources and agencies that help to provide for those who go without food and shoes and shelter and clothing and water. God, for those whose sunrises and sunsets are no longer able to be seen with their eyes. God, help us to find you in the small spaces of abundant blessings around us. Reveal yourself to us in new ways, that we may feel your presence, that we may live lives of generous gratitude as a reflection of all you've given to us. Help those who will endure pain this day because of traditions changed, of no family is around the table, or for whom the holidays are just difficult. God, wrap them in your love. Help them to find their strength in you and their wealth in you. These things we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. The Lord bless and keep you. The Lord's face shine upon you with grace and mercy. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. Amen. We'd love to extend an invitation to you before we go today. We worship here at St. Paul ELCA at 2293 East US Highway 40 in Altamont, Sunday mornings at 8:30. We would love to have you join us. Our worship service is recorded and posted later on, usually late morning or early afternoon on Sundays. So if you're finding this video, you'll find our worship videos there as well. We also invite you to the Lord's table, because the table is not that of St. Paul's. It's not that of the ELCA. It is not that of Pastor Maria or the people here. It is Jesus' table. And so we invite you to partake in that meal. It is through Jesus that everyone has a seat at the table. God's peace and blessings to you this day, as we give thanks to God for you. Take good care.